I am here in the middle of the first night of Rio's Carnival. Now let me tell you, just walking through this crowd, the energy is not to be believed. As a matter of fact, I can tell you, it's honestly one of the most magical experiences that I've ever had. I knew that I wanted to do some sort of a mega illusion here, but I also knew that it needed to be more than just a magic trick. It needed to mean something to the people of Brazil. And that meant I needed to go out and actually meet the people of Brazil. When I first got here, the only thing I'd known about Brazil was what I knew from CNN. That changed very quickly. Glass of water. And I need some money. What an amazing coincidence. All right. You take and roll up the money. Okay. You have the water. Watch. And that's for you. There you go. You can have that back. There you go. Obrigado. So I realized that probably the best subject for my magic would be this giant statue on the top of this mountain. It's what the Brazilians call Cristo Redentor. I think that's how you say it. Well, after taking a look at the statue, I realized that it would be possible to do something, but now the question was what to do with the statue. And for that, I knew that I would never know the answer. So I resorted to calling three friends of mine, local Brazilian magicians. We got together and they told me what they thought would be the most meaningful illusion for the people of Brazil.
Wow, very nice. Look at this. Franz Harary. Lembre-se desse nome, Franz Harary. É nesse lugar, Franz Harary. Aqui atrás também, na frente e atrás, na frente e atrás.
Maybe.
Oh, other version.
This one. Eu vou colocar em minha mão, assim, ok? Abra sua mão, ok? Abra, open your hand.
Abra.
Esta bola eu vou colocar na mão do Prince Fashion. E agora, um, dois, três. Open your hand.
Oh, unbelievable. Two
bolas. Yeah. Três bolas, huh? This.
Uh-huh. This. All right.
Open. Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
That looks pretty cool.
Like that.
Oh. What do I do with the crystal?
It's a good question.
I had one idea that I noticed that it faces its back to the city. So I thought about maybe turning it around.
Yeah, spinning
so that
around.
It faces towards the
great
people.
Idea. But or changing places.
Moving.
Yeah.
Moving.
Yeah.
Like, what, to São Paulo?
No.
You know what, if I move to São Paulo, then I will disappear. Suddenly, poof, yeah. Magic Boy is gone. What happened to him?
Sure.
Yeah. So,
moving to other mountain, maybe.
Is there a small mountain that is near the Cristo now?
Yeah, there is a mountain here. It's named the Pedra da Gávea.
Uh-huh.
It's a very famous symbol of Rio too.
I think what I want to try to do is move it, as you suggested,
yeah.
Take it from one place to the other. So now we just got to figure out how
what
to do
place?
It. Yeah, I don't know. Time for another site survey.
Welcome to Brazil.
Thank you. When I come back here in a couple of months, we'll get together.
Okay, free tickets.
Free tickets for all the magicians. All right, let's do one last thing. We're gonna make that camera disappear. All right?
Okay.
Yeah. At the count of three, we're all gonna snap our fingers and the camera disappears.
Yeah?
All right? One, two, three.
So now I knew I was gonna move the Cristo from one mountaintop to another mountaintop. And that meant two things. Firstly, I was gonna have to understand the layout, kind of learn the topography. Secondly, it was a chance for a helicopter ride. So once I had engineered everything out, I thought it was ready, except for one key element. This is Brazil, and nothing here happens without a permit. So it was off to get the blessing of the fire department.
I think the reality is this is all going to come down to whoever happens to be walking by at that particular moment.
Yeah, but they don't know.
The way I see it, we've only got about 20 degrees here that we can put our audience in.
Okay.
So then came the actual day of the illusion, and everything was in control, except for one thing, and that was by design. You see, the audience, I wanted completely out of my control. As a matter of fact, I didn't even invite anybody. I took my chances, because I figured if I had the illusion set up and I waited long enough, I could have normal people off the street, normal Brazilians and tourists walk up, and I could do this illusion for them. And in turn, they could become your representatives at home.
Well, how do I say, look here? All right, folks, it's magic time. I'm gonna take the jacket, okay? Now look here. Check it out, that is our subject. Now. Right over there. That's it. It's one. All right, time to bring him back. Cristo back where it belongs, in the end, I was able to share my magic with Brazil. And the truth is, Brazil shared its magic with me.